program verification is activity whose aim is to establish that program satisfies some desired properties.
This is Viktor Kuncak, a professor of the IC School at EPFL.
There are many different kinds of properties that one could ask about programs. You could ask whether the results that the program generates are the results that that you expect. So you usually have some specification that may be informal, given in some documents or some examples, and then you could formalize that. Often programs themselves can be used, the specifications. You can compare two versions of the program, or you can compare a simple program and a more complicated but more efficient program. And so verification tries to establish this correspondence between what the program is doing and what the program should be doing.
Okay, but verifying the correctness of something as mechanical as a computer program, how hard can that be?
Well, program verification often involves manipulation of arbitrary programs, and there are some fundamental theorems that say that if you have tasks that involve arbitrary programs, that means that there will be certain cases where you cannot perform them using an algorithm.
This is because of the infamous halting problem and its generalizations like Rice's theorem. These theorems assert that there is no algorithm that can automatically check whether other algorithms satisfy some non-trivial property. In other words, program verification is, in its general form, an undecidable problem.
In general, because the programs can exhibit arbitrary long behaviors, what program verification does is approximates all the possible behaviors. So as a result, we may not be able to establish all properties that are of interest.
But of course, this does not mean that specific problems of program verification are hopeless.
The goal is that programs that whose correctness can be argued in simple ways can be checked. And maybe there will be programs that are so tricky that nobody knows why they work, and those may be beyond the reach of automated verification tools.
After all, this is how mathematicians do mathematics. By Gödel's incompleteness theorem, mathematicians know that not all conjectures that they make will eventually be proved. But hopefully, some of the mathematical conjectures of interest will be, so that mathematical progress can be made.
I think this is something acceptable. So in general, the desire to establish program correctness is also compatible with the desire to keep our programs simple to reason about. So we would like to engineer systems that we can reason about, that have whose correctness can be established in a way that we can verify it independently, and then also tools will work. Automated tools can work better on these kinds of programs.
In fact, just like mathematical conjectures, human written codes are usually not arbitrary.
So if we have higher level programming languages that have simpler semantics and where certain natural concepts can be expressed in a more natural way, then this generally makes it easier to verify these programs. So that's, for example, why functional programming is a good match for program verification, because functional programs are closer to mathematical description of the desired functionality, and therefore building tools that use mathematical reasoning to prove program correctness is more effective.
We talked about this advantage of functional programming with Martin Ordosky in a previous video.
You can apply verification techniques to lower level code as well, and this is useful for certain kinds of software, but for those kinds of programs that we can express naturally using functional code, it's generally a more cost-effective way to use verification at this higher level of abstraction.
So what kind of tools are used in program verification?
There are various methodological approaches to constructing these tools. One well-known approach is abstract interpretation, where we approximate possible behaviors by replacing, for example, sets of possible values with some representations of these sets. For example, you could replace the set of integers with some intervals to which these that approximate the set. And then you can usually transform the computation of the exact set of reachable states into some fixed point computation that in case of appropriate approximations can be solved in finite amount of time. Often these approaches based on approximation can compute approximation first, and then you can ask questions about program, and some questions you'll be able to answer, some questions you will not be able to answer.
We'll discuss abstract interpretation in greater lengths in a future video.
When you try to establish more complicated properties, typically you want to take into account the program and the property that you want to establish at the same time, and then sort of go both from the program and from the property. This is often called property-directed approach to verification or analysis. And these approaches have been quite influential recently. So in that case, you could be going backwards from the properties and seeing what are the sufficient conditions to establish those properties. Often you, instead of using simple approximations, you would be using approximations that become more and more precise over time, and your analysis may not even necessarily terminate a priori, but you may simply stop it if you're not gaining any more information. So in that sense, a verification can be viewed as a process that establishes easier properties sooner, and some properties maybe it will never succeed in establishing.
As you can imagine, there's still a lot of research to be done in the domain.
But if you look at practical applications, we see more and more success on typical properties and typical programs, and also in the scale of programs that we are verifying. What makes it also interesting, in contrast to tools such as Scala check and some bounded model checkers, is that it can also prove correctness. If the software misbehaves, then there could be catastrophic failures that may result in major damage and also loss of human lives.